Hey there, Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja, and we're continuing our Hot Attic series. And today I want to talk to you about what some energy auditors say are one of the biggest wasters of energy in modern homes, and that's the recessed light. I want to teach you how to properly air seal and insulate it. And we're also going to talk about how to insulate and air seal those bathroom fans. Be sure to stay tuned to the end of the video because we're also going to share with you how you can get registered to win an April Air 1820 dehumidifier. Stay tuned. Okay, so if you're new to Crawl Space Ninja, we talk about everything dealing with your attic, basement, crawl space, and ductwork to improve the energy efficiency and indoor air quality of your home. So if you like this kind of information, make sure you subscribe to our channel down below and ring that notification bell. It's hard to find a house built today without recessed lights or can lights all throughout the house. As a matter of fact, we've done several attic jobs where recessed lights counted up to 60 and 70. Inside the house. Can you imagine? 60 to 70 recessed lights, and many of those recessed lights actually have floodlights put in them. So that would be the first thing I would recommend you do. You go up there and you pull out all of those floodlights, those hot floodlights that are up in those recessed lights, and you replace them with LED lights that run way cooler, because you don't want to have a floodlight, because that becomes a non-IC rated light. In other words, non-insulation contact. So you're not supposed to have any insulation within 3 inches of a non-IC rated light. And if you do that, if you have an IC rated light where you can have insulation contacting the light, then it's okay to install the can light covers or the recessed light covers, which both insulate and air seal those recessed lights. Now, this is an example of one of my favorite recessed light covers. There's several out there. Some are made of cardboard, some are made of rock wool, and different things like that. You can even make them out of drywall. You can just take drywall and cut it and air seal it with maybe a fire retardant foam or something like that, because believe it or not, drywall is actually considered to be a fire retardant substance, okay? So you can do that. Just make sure you get it at least 3 to 4 inches away from the recessed lights if you're gonna custom build one. If you have floodlights installed, if you have LED lights or a cooler light installed, then you can use something like this. And this is made of rock wool. This is called a Tenmat light cover. And I'm gonna put a link down below in the description if you wanna get a few of these. But basically what I like about this is it's completely customizable. It's easy to cut with a razor knife. And as you can see in this video, we actually have two of them lined up where we have a bathroom fan, where we got the exhaust coming out of the fan, because that's another big energy waster, is those bathroom fans or other exhaust fans that you might have inside the house. And then right next to it, we have a recessed light. And a lot of times you'll have a stud right next to the recessed light or different things like that. So you can custom cut these little guys and then use some good spray foam. If it's an IC rated light, you can use our spray foam that we've got down below in the description. If it's a non-IC rated light and you're dealing with a really hot recessed light cover, I recommend you get a fireproof caulk or something like that that you can use just to make sure that you don't have any kind of fire hazard or smoke hazard up in the attic. Okay, so once this is installed, then you can blow your insulation or put your bat insulation around that light, whatever you're using to insulate the attic. Now, one of the interesting things about recessed lights is they're notorious for wasting energy. And as a matter of fact, the Pennsylvania Housing Research Center says that one recessed light can cost you up to $35 per light per year. So if you are thinking whether or not you should install a recessed light cover, that ought to give you reason enough right there. I really hope you like this information, and I'd sure appreciate it if you hit the like button down below. And now I want to tell you how to get registered for that April Air 1820 dehumidifier. Below in the description is all the instructions you'll need to know on how to get registered for the dehumidifier. So my name is Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja, and we hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.